Good morning, children. I, Mrs. S.K. Singh, welcome you to the first session of online chemistry class. This is your book, and your first chapter is Matter and Its Composition. So we begin the explanation of chapter 1. We know that our universe is made up of matter and energy. We are surrounded by matter. The air we breathe in, the water we drink, the clothes we wear, the food we eat, and the land over which we walk also are termed as matter. In fact, all the substances that surround us constitute matter. So in short, we can say matter is something which occupies space, has mass, and can be perceived by our senses. Air also is matter because it occupies space and has mass. Thus we can see by the following activity. To prove that air occupies space, we take a deflated football, we fill air into it, we see that the football acquires a definite shape, a round shape. From this we conclude that air occupies space or matter occupies space. Now to prove that air has mass, we take a horizontal bar, we take two equal sized balloons and we inflate them equally, and now we fix the two balloons on either side from the center of the horizontal bar, and we see that the bar is in balanced condition. Now we puncture the right side balloon, we see that the balloon gets deflated and the rod tilts on the left side, proving that the balloon which was on the left side was heavier, and since matter or air occupies space, the bar tilts on the left side. This activity proves that matter has mass. Sound, magnetism, love, hate, these emotions are not considered as matter. Why? Because neither they occupy space nor they have mass. Now we come to the topic of states of matter. Matter is present in three physical states, namely solid, liquids and gas. The liquid and gaseous states are called fluid states because they can easily flow. A liquid can be poured from one vessel to another. Moreover, these states of matter are interconvertible, that is, they can change from one form to another by changing the temperature. For example, solid on heating changes into liquid, and liquid on heating changes into gas. On the other side, if you cool gas, it gets converted into liquid, and if you cool liquid, it gets converted into solid. Now the next question comes, what is matter made up of? Matter is made up of atoms and molecules. I have given you this definition before also. An atom is the smallest particle of matter which may or may not exist independently but takes part in a chemical reaction, whereas a molecule is the smallest particle of matter which can exist independently. And now we come to important properties of solid, liquids and gases. We start with solid state. In solids, the molecules are closely packed, held by strong force of attraction. There is no intermolecular space between them, or it is almost negligible. They have a fixed shape and do not flow. They also occupy a definite volume and cannot be compressed. The intermolecular space is least in solids due and the force of attraction is maximum. Now we come to liquid state. In liquid state, the molecules are loosely packed and there is very less intermolecular space existing between them. They have no fixed shape, that is, they take the shape of the container into which they are poured and all liquids can flow easily. They have a definite volume and so they can be compressed slightly. The attractive force between the molecules of liquid is less as compared to the molecules of solid, and on heating the liquid molecules expand. Now, to show that liquid molecules diffuse easily, we take two beakers and pour equal amount of water and milk into it. Now we pour the contents of these two beakers into a third beaker. We see a uniform solution is obtained. Now what happens when we mix the two liquids, that is water and milk? The molecules of water occupy the space between the molecules of milk, and hence the intermixing of the two different type of molecules lead to the formation of a solution, or in short we can say that liquid can diffuse into another liquid. Now when we come to the properties of gases. In gases, the molecules are very loosely packed, or we can also say that they are far apart from one another. There is a large intermolecular space existing between them. They do not have a definite shape. They take up the shape of the container into which they are poured, or they fill the entire space available to them. Gases show the property of diffusion. We can explain it by a simple example. Open a bottle of perfume in one corner of the room. You get the smell of perfume into the another corner. Why? Because the gas molecules drift easily through the air molecules, and so they reach our nose and we get the smell of it. And the gas molecules have high kinetic energy. I've told you that matter is composed of atom and molecules, and these atom and molecules are in constant random motion, so they possess kinetic energy. This kinetic energy is maximum in case of gases, next liquids, and very less in case of solids. To explain the process of diffusion, you can also take example of incense sticks given in activity number 5. Now children, till here only we will cover the topic, and I am sending you a PDF of the first chapter, that is matter and its composition. Read the chapter 3 to 4 times so that you are able to understand the concepts properly when I am sending the video. Along with the PDF of the chapter, I am sending you a worksheet also on the chapter, on the topic taught today. So what you will do, you will take a notebook and you will write all the answers by taking reference of page number 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. For your reference, I am reading out the question. State three properties of matter. How will you prove that air occupies space? How will you prove that air has mass? Sound and magnetism are not regarded as matter. Why? Define atoms and molecules and state four important properties of solid, liquid and gaseous state each. So please complete the work in your notebook, and I'll be coming very soon with the next video session of the same chapter, that is matter and its composition. So till then, be safe, be happy and stay indoors. Thank you.